This year we started the Urban October celebrating the World Habitat Day and reflecting on public spaces for all. We do it in a partnership between UN Habitat and the He for She initiative promoted by UN Women. It aims to engage men and boys, one half of humanity, in removing the social and cultural barriers that prevent the other half of the humanity from achieving their potential. This partnership examines and promotes the role for men and women alike in the creation of gender equal public spaces for all. Good public space enhances community cohesion and promotes health, happiness, and well-being for all citizens, as well as fostering investment, economic development, and environmental sustainability. The character of a city is defined by its streets and public spaces. From squares and boulevards to neighborhoods, gardens, and children playgrounds, public spaces frames city image. The connective matrix of streets and public spaces forms the skeleton of the city upon which all the rest is created. Public space is a vital component of a prosperous city. Well designed and managed, public space is a key asset for a city's functioning and has a positive impact on its economy, as I said, its environment, safety, health, integration, connectivity, even culture. The quality of life for people in cities is directly related to the state of the public spaces. Public space provides room for a social and cultural interaction and can foster a sense of belonging and pride in a given area. A public space that is open to all, regardless of ethnic origins, age or gender, provides a democratic forum for citizens and society. Public space can bring communities together, provide meeting places, and foster social ties. These spaces shape the cultural identity of an area, are part of its unique character, and provide a sense of place for local communities. Sharing common spaces is the soul of the city. Where public space is inadequate, poorly designed or privatized, the city becomes increasingly segregated. The result can be a polarized city where social tensions are likely to flare up and where crime and violence rises. A mixed and diverse public space provides a place that is vibrant and busy, automatically, in fact, reducing insecurity. Many cities are developing policies that promote compact, livable areas with adequate public spaces that facilitate public transport, encourage walking and cycling, thereby reducing carbon emissions. Public space is critical for environmental sustainability, though. Green and open public space brings many important environmental benefits, such as cooling of air and absorbing of atmospheric pollutants, and the significant increase in hard surfacing and the reduction in green spaces led to higher temperatures in towns and cities. Vegetation in the public space can help to readdress this imbalance. Although a good city performance is not only about the amount of public space only, we see successful urban grids when public space is in balance and well connected with the buildable plots. Like in a perfect yin and yang, a city should allocate to open spaces, parks, squares and plazas at least the same proportion as to the buildable space, to the private sector. Given the importance of public space, it is worrying that provision of public space is limited in many cities, that access to public space is becoming more and more controlled, and that often, cities lack comprehensive knowledge of the public space they have and manage, and also they lack the management mechanisms to enhance its quality, its access, and therefore providing its benefits. In addition, tools for creating and protecting public spaces are not widely applied and accessible to cities across the world, and in particular in developing countries. An enormous local asset is undervalued and underutilized. We should all ensure that in the framework of the transforming of our world, the 2030 Development Agenda, especially Sustainable Development Goal number 11, which formulates the ambition to make cities and human settlements inclusive, safe, resilient and sustainable, we reflect on the need to plan and manage public spaces. The new urban agenda to be defined in Habitat 3 in Quito in 2016 will provide a unique opportunity to implement the 2030 Development Framework and deal with the challenges of urbanization in the next 2 decades. Thank you very much.